The latest in the Ludi controversy.
You're just a true double six like Ludi.
The hottest name in gospel right now.
You make me stronger.
Shares his inspiring story. New Roots Rocker finds a victory.
Sleepless nights under pressure, got a lot on my mind.
And for the first time in Jamaica,
we have a truck on the road.
All of four carnivals on the road for Carnival Sunday.
We love it, Sam!
E-news reviews and more in the mix. All coming up right here on stage. I am Winford Williams. We'll be right back.
Positively clear when I light up on Richard.
Reaching more and more screens around the world every week on stage. So much more than entertainment.
Welcome back. Dominating our e-news and reviews this week is the Ludi controversy. Here's Jason Williams.
Carnival Sunday would ordinarily be the biggest entertainment story coming out of the week. But on Monday, when an upload on Vibes Cartel's Vivo, said to be the original version of Ludi, with a cryptic message saying, "My song was never a collaboration," surfaced online, the internet went wild. Ludi, featuring Vibes Cartel's vocals on the chorus, is the song that many would say made Shensia the undisputed breakout female dancehaller of 2016 and was released last November.
Actually, So Unique song, actually. Okay. Elvis from So Unique Records.
Oh, Elvis.
Okay. Came up with an agreement with my manager, Ramesh Major,
to do this
feature
record
on the song.
Who is the feature?
I was the feature on the song.
So it's a Cartel song?
Yes, that
featuring
they had
you.
Before.
But the original version has lyrics that are very similar to the verses Shensia performed on her version.
Do the verb with the noun with the subject.
Not uncommon in music globally, but Shensia's manager Ramesh's claim right here on stage that she writes her own music seemed to have caused the online firestorm that came their way.
Just the other day, Ramesh was on our show and people were praising him, saying that the interview was very inspirational.
You know, I'm a businessman, so I get that fight from day one.
All
so.
Sorts of great things. Now he's been called a con artist. And Shensia, the Gaza fans from all over the world have come to really give it to her.
Shensia and Ramesh responded to us exclusively like this.
It's not like Elvis sent the song and said, "Yo, Shensia must do it." Send the song and say, "Yo, what them would have like a female," and because Jigga Jigga just come out and she's a new face and everything. Well, we said, okay then, fine. That's Vibes Cartel. Who wouldn't want to do a collab or a song with him?
I modified the lyrics. And with the original being out, it shows that I did modify the lyrics and I did add lyrics to the song to make it more spicier. I add my own touch, as Elvis said I should. I did what I had to do, and it just been going far and far and further every time, and it's that some people just cannot take.
Since our interview aired on Tuesday, the producer in question, Elvis, posted a response to the situation online where he corroborated Ramesh's story and gave further insight into the matter. The version of Ludi featuring Just Vibes Cartel has since been removed from YouTube.
And for the first time in the history of Carnival celebration in Jamaica, all of four carnivals on the road for the climatic Carnival Sunday. Here's Jason Williams.
Lots of colors, costumes, trucks, and excitement on the streets of Kingston City. The aggregate number of revelers on the road clearly making last Sunday's Carnival parade the biggest it has been in Jamaica for many years. Jamaica Carnival's return to the road was modest, but shows signs of returning in 2018. Jamaica also looking like 2018 will be promising. Dream Entertainment's Exodus, a big winner on the road. Numbers putting them close to the market leader.
I never expect this at all. The vibe is good, the alcohol is good. I'm almost drunk, but it's amazing. I will love it.
It's been one of my best carnival experiences of all my life. From Barbados to Trinidad to Jamaica, it's been one of my best.
But though faced with heavy competition this year, Bacchanal Jamaica, based on the number of costumed revelers on the road, still remains the biggest carnival in Jamaica.
One of the brands responsible for bringing the vibes here on Carnival Sunday is Rum Bar, and they are first-time sponsors of Carnival in Jamaica. And this is Bacchanal Jamaica. We're here with the marketing manager, Omar. Talk to us about the vibe here on the road.
Well, the vibe has been good so far. I mean, let me tell you, man. Came out early this morning, and everything was pretty much on time, and I tell you, the vibe has been good. Great.
And what made you guys decide to be a part of Carnival Bacchanal Jamaica this year?
Well, we decided that, here what, Rum Bar is going to be heading back out to the streets. We're going to get back into all the sponsorships, and we're going to make a little more noise again. So we decided to start with Bacchanal. I mean, look at the vibe here. Bacchanal is one of those events that pretty much has everybody out on the streets. And this is our way of reintroducing Rum Bar to the masses.
Talk to us about the activation for Rum Bar on the road here today.
Well, right now we have our truck, as you can see. We have a few of our Rum Bar girls out here. And I mean, we're just pretty much going to be having a lot of excitement later at the show itself. But right now, a major thing is our Rum Bar branded truck with all our promoters bringing up the vibe.
And is this year a trial and error kind of thing, or is there a partnership that will be fostered over the years?
No trial and error. This is going to be a partnership for years to come. So Rum Bar will definitely be back on board next year with Bacchanal Jamaica Carnival.
And how would you sum up this carnival season? It's coming to an end today. I mean, you guys were at Bacchanal Fridays. Talk to us about the whole carnival season this year.
Well, the 6 weeks of Bacchanal Fridays, it was very good for us, because a lot of persons, you know, we're a little skeptical in our Rum Bar in Carnival, but the reception has been wonderful. I mean, our gold rum has been well accepted, and persons are like, yo, where was this product all this time? So we say, well, it has been there, you know, but we're showcasing it now. So over the 6 weeks, very wonderful reception, lots of good feedback, and we, as I said, we will be back at it again next year.
It's always good vibes, good energy, you know, them don't mix the carnival soca music with a little dance also, you know, we enjoy it even more.
I'm on the fame road, fame truck, turn up to the book, then wine and make a long bar, I'm just enjoying myself.
It's been a great thing. I mean, every year I watch the carnival grow, and I watch the vibes open up, and I watch that Jamaica looking at carnival in different ways, different angles, a little curious than before. So it's a blessing this year. I had a good time. The rain was supposed to fall and it didn't fall. So I give thanks for that too.
Ribby's Ultra Lounge was all the craze on Monday night in celebration of the man himself, Brian Ribby Chung, who, according to partners Kamal Banke and Don Creary, was celebrating his 33rd birthday.
We are here live and direct, yes, at the only place to be on a Monday night, Ribby's Ultra Lounge, celebrating with Mr. 33 himself.
Mr. 33 year old.
Yeah, he's 33 today.
You know, we love Ribby, everybody love Ribby. Ribby is a partner, our brother, our friend, everything. And we're here to celebrate with him tonight and celebrate him. He is like a father of entertainment, even at 33.
And though many didn't buy the 33, clearly Ray and Nephew did, for all of $500,000.
When you have valued consumers, you have to treat them right. So we said, let us cover his bill 6 months on us.
Thank you, Jay, Ray and Nephew.
Everybody will come up for Ray because he's real to people and people are real to him. We love you, Ribby!
A wonderful friend. He keeps going and going and going. He will never die. He's only 6 years of age.
Happy birthday, Ribby. All the best to you, my love.
Happy birthday to my brother, Ribby. Wish you many, many more great success. You're doing it. You set the trend for event planners like myself, and wish you many, many more.
Every year, I invite my friends and family, and I'm happy that they all come out tonight.
All right, we take a break right here, but still to come right here on stage, gospel's hottest name shares inspiring story. Father, protect me. New roots rocker finds a victory. But first, Appleton Signature Nights goes to Mandeville after the break.
Reaching more and more screens around the world every week. On stage, so much more than entertainment.
We'll be right back. Welcome back. After launching in 2016, Appleton Estate has returned with its signature nights, the blending of brand awareness and music. Their most recent stop was in Mandeville. And guess who? You guessed it. Jason Williams was there.
The venue is the lawns of OMG Restaurant here in Mandeville, and the person tasked with bringing the music is none other than Sanchez. If his history of amazing performances in Jamaica is anything to go by, forever. Listen, the patrons tonight are in for a fantastic night.
My head is anointed and my cup running over when the road is started.
It is us trying to connect with our consumers to share the essence of the brand with the, let's say, common Jamaican. So they can consume at their favorite place of whether community bar or style bar.
We're one of Appleton's customers, and they chose to do something in the central Manchester area, and we were blessed with the opportunity that they chose us.
And a fantastic night it was on Thursday.
Enjoyed it immensely. Beautiful setting, etc., etc. Fun.
Sanchez was nothing short of exceptional.
It's awesome. I would do it all over again. Like, it's Sanchez. What do we expect? I love him.
Well, I'm hoping that this is not the last one, eh? I am enjoying myself. Clean, nice entertainment. Sanchez outdid himself this time again.
I grew up listening to Sanchez, and even with the change of music over the years, I still gravitate towards his kind of music.
It's like off the chain. I can't describe it, man. It was awesome. It was, I would say, exceeding what I was looking for. So it was great.
Talk to us about when you got the call to be a part of Appleton Estate's signature nights, and what was that?
It was the greatest, one of the greatest. Because you know, Appleton has been around for years. It's, I would say, a landmark. It's Jamaica's number one room.
Appleton Estate's Signature Nights series will continue monthly throughout 2017. And will feature various artists at various venues across the island.
We're all in this thing together.
Ensure that once you hear the advertised date for the other activations, that you make yourself present, because what we experienced tonight was second to none.
All right, still to come right here on stage, Roots Rocker finds victory, and later, Gospel's Hottest Name shares inspiring story coming up.
You make me stronger.
More and more screens around the world every week. On stage, so much more than entertainment.
Welcome back. His name has been featured in what is called the Roots Rock Reggae Revolution in Jamaica.
I got some problems, I keep you up like coffee.
Born in a musical family, his life's journey has given him influences from Tanzania, Ethiopia, the United States, and his birthplace, Jamaica.
You're hiding in the darkness.
After releasing his debut EP 4 years ago, he has now found victory in his newest project. And he's right here on our stage right now to share all of it with you. We're talking about Kez Namde right now, right here on stage. Kez, welcome, sir.
Yeah, everything good.
Good to have you. Yeah. All right, go ahead and explain the victory for us. Victory.
Well, Victory is the new song, is the lead out single of the new project Skyline Levels. Mm-hmm. And it's featuring Chronix. And really, the topic is really just about overcoming struggles, you know?
Yes.
And that's really what the song is about.
All right, great. So we have the video for it coming up shortly. But first, give me a summary of your journey in music.
Well, you know, as you said a while ago, our first project that we dropped out to the world was the Bridging the Gap EP.
Yes.
That was about 3 years ago. And, you know, lucky enough for us, we were in the top charts for the reggae billboards and reggae iTunes. And since that, we've been just dropping a lot of singles. And then, you know, along the way, we have been lucky enough to work with a lot of great people. We worked with Sony signed artists, Sony / Columbia signed artist Zoo.
Okay.
And we did, that was a special little recording because we recorded a song As Crazy As It Is. Its titles are As Crazy As It Is, and we were able to hit the dance charts, and a lot of Jamaicans don't even see those charts. So it was a great platform for me to go on, and not only for me as Keznamni, but even for just Jamaica to be on that platform, you know. And we did a lot of touring with Chronix as well, you know. We did some of the biggest reggae festivals around the world.
Including Sunfest in Jamaica.
Including Sunfest Jamaica. We did UCLA Jazz and Reggae Festival, Belgium Reggae Guild, Reggae on the River, Reggae on the Mount, just to name a few. And after that, that was last year, and after that, we just went in the studio to work on the project.
And the timeline for all of that is what?
Just 3 years.
3 years.
Yeah.
Amazing.
Yeah.
So how would you define your fan base? Who are
my fan base? Well, my fan base, very young, you know what I mean? Scattered all around the world.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? When I mean scattered all around the world. Yesterday, we did a post that we're just telling people that we're planning our new tour, and we're just saying everybody to send in the comments where's the city, and we were getting everywhere. Toronto, Belgium, Ghana, Ethiopia, Trinidad, and, you know, our fan base, they're very interactive with us, you know what I mean, on social media. When you see my fan base, when they message me in my inbox, in my Instagram, I reply to every one of them. We have a very close-knit relationship.
Yes.
Yeah.
One gets the sense that there is a convergence going on of the beats of Africa. Do you get that sense?
I think for me, my story is a little bit different because, you know, I grew up in Jamaica.
Yes.
When I was around 12, 13, mommy come home and say, yo, we're moving to Tanzania.
Yes.
And at that time, I didn't even know what Tanzania was. Mm-hmm. You know, we lived there for 3 years, and then after that, we went to Ethiopia for another 3 years. And then after that, we went to California for another 3 years. So because of that, of my travels, I've been exposed to a lot of different genres
and cultures,
music,
and
different
music
cultures,
and
different foods.
Okay, yeah. I know.
Hear that in music.
I know the family. Yeah, so. The family is well-traveled. Yeah. And so. You as kids, you all your Camila, your sister Camila, the famous Camila, trainer now, former TV host, right here on stage.
Yeah,
and so why didn't you do an album? Because it's about 8 tracks on this new EP, right?
Because I'm working on my album right now.
Oh, so you're also working on an album?
Yeah, so I started working on it probably just conceptualizing it about literally 2 months ago.
Oh,
and this EP or project or body of work, whatever you want to call it, is really a prequel for the album.
Okay, good. Good news. Because I know that sometimes Jamaicans are not doing albums.
Yeah.
And I was wondering if you're skipping that.
Nah, man.
Oh, okay, great. That's good news. We're talking about it earlier.
Yeah.
All right, so let's go to the video now, sir. Yeah. Victory, right here. Can't keep it down, cause we have to. Sleepless nights under pressure, got a lot on my mind. But with life be without all these struggles of mine. Can't sleep, so my steam trees for peace of mind. I can't sleep, but these sweet dreams do ease my mind. I say, what success without a little sacrifice? With every downfall, yes, you have to ever rise. Only Jah know my history, so we have to give the King glory. Like a tree planted by the river, I smile when the sun can't keep you down, cause we have to overcome. Wow, victory indeed. Keznamni. Wow. What a record. That's a song, sir.
Yeah,
all I have to say is that's a record. That's a true song.
Yeah, man.
I like it. Nice.
Yeah.
Okay, so where do you go? Talk about your future. Where do you go from here? What's
Well, right
what's
now,
in there?
We're preparing with the band now to hit the road. So we're doing some promoting here in Jamaica. We're going to be here for a little bit. We're doing a special acoustic jam show here in Jamaica on May 6th.
Okay.
We're going to be keeping our big show in October, but we wanted to do one special intimate performance May 6th at One Malines Road.
Mm-hmm. Is this just two weeks from, well, just a week away from
now? Yeah. And we're going to be doing a nice little performance. So,
oh,
yeah.
Nice. So fans can come out and see it.
And it's free, so everybody come out.
Free for all to come out?
Yeah, free to come through.
And your summer is looking how?
So we're lining up a lot of club dates. Mm-hmm. So because we just dropped the project now, we're not going to be doing any festivals right now because we want to hit the real intimate performances in the clubs.
Okay.
So we're going to be doing a lot of club performances. Right?
Well, with this track, I see a very busy future coming up for you, young man.
Yeah.
Thanks for coming and sharing with us, sir. And all the very best, and keep us abreast of all the progress.
All right. Yeah.
All right, stay with us. Still to come right here on stage. Gospel's leading man. We'll be back. You make me stronger.
Come on. Say, you make me stronger.
Reaching more and more screens around the world every week. On stage. So much more than entertainment.
Welcome back. If the word hot can be ascribed to a gospel artist, that artist is Kevin Downswell. Today I rise. Born in Westmoreland, Jamaica, and raised across four parishes on the island, as a young man, Downswell had great hopes of becoming a medical doctor and was well on his way to achieving that objective when he found his true calling. Mighty awakening. The year was 2003, and young Kevin, a student at the University of the West Indies, enrolled in a biochemistry degree program. Kevin entered and won JCDC's annual gospel song competition that year, and soon after emerged a recording artist. In 2005, just 2 years later, not only was Downswell an accomplished artist in the gospel arena, he was also an ordained evangelist. And though he was able to finish the degree in biochemistry that same year, all hopes of becoming a doctor sunk.
Back to Jamaica.
Downswell became a full-fledged music ministry who is now the hottest name in gospel and is our very special guest right now, right here on our stage.
Thank you for
Kevin,
having me.
Sir.
Hot.
Oh, yes. If there's a word in my view, I'm the one saying this, not you. You're
Thank
not
you.
Saying it, but I'm saying it. Okay? I'm saying, sir, that in the last four years? I think it's about 4 years. There is no question about who's gospel's leading man from where I sit.
Wow. The important thing is for me, mm-hmm. that's not the focus.
Okay.
My focus is way beyond just being the head or the lead or number one or number two. My focus is purpose.
Clearly.
And so if purpose gets you to a place where people celebrate you like that, then it's not mine to embrace it, but mine to just say I'm grateful.
Yeah, because you have the attention.
Yeah, I'm to God be all the glory.
Yeah, because that's the first step, you know, to get the people's attention, which you do have. All right, so take us back to 2003, okay? When you emerged a recording artist.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
You were an artist before, you were in music
before.
What changed? What was the single biggest reason why you decided now, I have found my calling?
Well, Tasty Talent Contest used to happen before that. So I think I did about three where I came up, the best place that I've ever placed in Tasty is third.
Yes.
That was how tough Tasty Talent Competition was.
Okay.
Tasty's focus was connecting with your audience. Mm-hmm. Tasty was, that's what they were all about. Digging in, there's this gap between you and your audience, find a way to connect with them.
Oh, that moment on stage, that live moment.
Yes. So when I got to JCDC Gospel Festival in 2003, mm-hmm. performance was natural because over the years, I grew to become a natural performer. But what they stressed was connecting with audience. Mm-hmm. Don't lose your audience. Find a way to engage that audience for that 3.5 minutes that you have on stage. Don't let them blink 1 sec. Mm-hmm. So JCDC gave me a platform and a stage. It was a massive stage. All of Jamaica were singing the songs, the top 10 songs. Okay. And let me big up my uncle, Lubert Levy, because I was focused on school. I wasn't interested in entering no competition. My focus was just medicine, school.
Right,
school,
then
school.
You were enrolled in the degree program.
Biochemistry. Mm-hmm. And so he said, why don't us enter the festival? And I'm like, I don't have the time. Mm-hmm. And him said, you know, try it, man. And I said, okay, let me try. And the rest is history. Okay. I mean, I won the top prize. I was shocked, to be honest, I was shocked. It was a massive moment for me.
So the win was what you would say is the biggest reason why you now say, this is what I want to do?
When,
or was there a spiritual awakening as well?
The spiritual awakening is the best part of it. Because when I won, I really wanted to go back to studying. I really had no intention to continue. I was encouraged to enter. I entered and I saw what was happening, but my real focus was finishing school. Finish school first. But while I was in school and I finished up biochemistry now, here we go. My real focus was medicine. And so applied for medicine, got through, start celebrating, I went for it. Start jumping, call my good friend who is now my wife. Mm-hmm.
I wish she was your good friend at the time.
Called her and said, hey, I got you. And she's like, oh, man, she's screaming. And I say, I'm going to get books now and everything. And by the time September, August, September, a first revelation came.
Okay.
Totally. It's like, this is me now, in prayer, talking to the Lord. And all of a sudden, you just felt this thing come over you. Medicine is not for you. I rebuked the voice. I said, this is not God. And so weeks after that, the voice came back, medicine is not for you. You're called to do what I'm doing now. And I'm like, no, this is not about it. No. I thought, and I said, boy, I was born for this. I was born to be a medical doctor. I was born to this. But not realizing that was here, not here.
Okay.
Medicine was what people told me, that's the best degree, that's the best thing, that brings you the most money. But my heart was way beyond that. I had to surrender. To be honest, for about 3-4 weeks, I say, how could you do this to me, God? Come years after years, may I study and I focus after this, and then you come change my path like this. How could you do this to me? Go on stage, because I would still have events. Go on stage, minister to people, come off a stage and say, God, why would you do this to me? And God just said to me, if you trust me, I'll blow your mind.
And the scientist in you was removed. No longer.
Let's put it like this. Yeah. When you serve an all-knowing God who knows all things, and you in your limited knowledge, trying to hold on to something that's not really yours, that you feel is yours, sometimes the best thing to do is just let go. And looking back now, at 2004, 5, 6, 7, at those decisive years, I'm saying to myself, why did I give God that fight? I'm looking back and I'm saying, wow.
So, okay, so it's 2003, up to 7, 8, 9.
Yeah.
You were still progressing, right?
Yes.
In gospel?
Yes.
But your prominence you're now enjoying mm-hmm. came when?
2008, we launched the first album, Close mm-hmm. to You. The song Close to You became like an anthem mm-hmm. In Jamaica and the Caribbean.
Okay.
And you would travel to places like Canada, US, and people would just sing the song in their praise and worship mm-hmm. session in church. And you're like, wow. 2012, now we launched the second album, Search Continues, and You Make Me Stronger. Mm-hmm. If it's not you, then Lord, it's already done, those songs were on it. And the songs, the album just went like this, bam. Africa, Germany, you get messages from everywhere. And we're like, this is without intentional promotion.
Yes.
This without having a label on board.
Just a song out there floating.
Just a song.
Binding.
Put on YouTube. You would get calls from Africa, Germany, Russia, sir, wherever. People saying, bro, your song is changing this place. Where you get this song from? I'm like, and it takes me back to where I wrote the song. I wrote the song when I was going through some hell. And I didn't have an express valve. I didn't have nobody to talk to. And I just went in the living room, grabbed a pen and a paper and said, boy, Father God, I don't know what's going on, I don't know what you're doing, but my trust and me, I just declare that right here, sir, you're my creator. You know my times. My seasons of breakthrough, my seasons of trials. So I will seek you and you will find. I didn't write the song to become popular. I didn't write the song for it to be popular. It was just a song that came from the heart, saying to God, I don't know what I do, but I feel so in the middle of this, in the middle of what I go on, you're making me stronger.
The whole world is out to it.
Boom. Yeah. And so 2012 was the real, was where it went boom. It just, the four walls of the box just went, just blow up, fire catch it, everything mash up. Mm-hmm. The limits were completely taken off. In the midst of all of that, the Lord was also teaching me to stay humble, because in with all the cars you're getting, all the shows and all the travel, you're not reaching over yet. You just break the surface. So try not to pop your color. Try not to absorb the praise for yourself.
Humility.
Remember who started this, and remember who's going to take you beyond this.
All right, so the music got the attention of not just Jamaicans, but people all over the world. What keep them, though? When they get to know you, when they come to your concert, what's keeping them? Is it the music still? They continue to feed them with music? Or is there something, is it your ministry, as you would call it in Christendom?
One of my mentors said to me, Kevin is a minister who sings,
yes,
not a singer who ministers.
Oh.
And I've never forgotten that.
So you embrace that? You believe that is the...
Yes, Mike. When I'm on a stage and I grab a mic, my first focus is, you see those eyes looking back at me? I want to make sure that you leave knowing, being encouraged, being inspired, knowing who God is. I don't want you to leave out of the building that we're in or wherever you are at, same way that you came in. So my focus is always to reach the heart. That was always my focus. Because there's somebody over there on that side of the audience who might be thinking, yo, I want to give up now. There may be a husband who might be saying, boy, I can't deal with this marriage no more. One word from my mouth could change all of that. Mm-hmm. You'll never hear me sing a song for just wave your hand. Let me see you move your body for Jesus. No. Because the bottom line of what I'm saying is exactly what God wanted me to say and what God wanted me to speak in your life for you to realize that all of this, he can take you through it and bring it over. I don't believe that we should make it our goal to be better than anybody or to compare ourselves. I believe it comes as a part of what God do. Mm-hmm. But the focus should be what's ahead. The focus should be what God plays inside our heart, and we're going after that no matter what. Blindfolds on, and because at the end of the day, just like somebody could say you're good at this, somebody could say you're terrible at this. Mm-hmm. Just like somebody could praise you today, them could rebuke you tomorrow. And so it's important for us to know that when Paul said, I do this, I don't do this for the applause of men. I do this for the glory of God. It's important for us, especially gospel artists, to remind ourselves that the applause is good, you know. The screams are awesome, but don't forget that the glory goes to God.
You must be winning young souls,
yes,
aren't you? You're winning souls.
Oh my gosh.
Lots of young souls.
It's humbling. It's amazing to see kids, Winford, kids, 2, 3, 4 year old. Even mummies would leave messages on Facebook saying, my baby, I'm in my second trimester, and when I play your music, my baby dancing on my belly. My baby just born, and she's 6 months old. And when she cry, once I put on your music, it's amazing. Then you go to the teenagers. and you realize their response to your music. You visit the schools and you see them in the audience, and once you go on stage and you go, 24 hours a day, the response. Mm-hmm. I'm grateful, but I realize that it's a responsibility. It's important for me to not just be carried away with the fact that I have such a great following, but it's important for me to be level-headed and to know that these guys need direction. And it's important for me to know that when I go on a stage like this, they're listening, they're watching, and they're using my life too, believe it or not, as much as we as artists, secular and gospel, disown the fact that we are somewhat fathers to some of these guys mm-hmm. and mentors.
You don't disown it. You feel you have a responsibility.
I embrace it. I mean, mother and daddy will do their part. Guardians will do their part. But if they listen to us so much every day with their earbuds in their ears, mm-hmm. 24 hours a day, sometimes fall asleep.
You must be influencing them.
So it's important for us for me to know that in as much as they love me, care for what me I say, mm-hmm. lead them in the right direction. I can't say everything what me want to say all the time. Mm-hmm. I have to listen what God wants me to say. Because I don't know exactly what them I got you, but he knows. So when he inspired me and said, Kevin, I want you to write this song, and I want you to say this, nobody loves me the way you do, and release that ain't coming from Kevin. Get to them, and he keep them focused, and he keep them strong. Nothing else. Mm. There's nothing more. It's priceless to just see them walk in those words.
Now, you performed a lot with Secular. Sometimes the only person, in a lot of cases, the only. When you're booked, you're being booked now, I sometimes notice, as just an artist. And you're on secular platforms, the biggest of them. And it's like nobody can walk around you, Kevin. And how do you feel about that? Being able to play to the secular,
my brother,
to be rubbing shoulder with dance owners.
To God be the glory, because when an artist, when somebody be a secular artist would walk over, shake your hand and say, boss, your song, them bless me. That's big. Mm-hmm. That's big. Because we preach with this, but we preach with the lifestyle.
Do you get a pushback from Christendom?
Absolutely not.
You don't get what the turncoats, as we call them, God from gospel, because they were not trusted initially. I don't know what their status is right at the moment, but they were not trusted by Christendom. They were getting followed in some quarters. They were getting a pushback for they didn't trust them as real Christians. Mm-hmm. Do you get any of that, given the fact that you're performing in the secular space?
Not really. For one of the things I try to keep around me is solid mentors. Mm-hmm. You will get a message from somebody now and then to say, why are you putting this song on an EDM? Stuff like that.
Yes.
Stop. No one, like Goodbye World now, we're having this video. And why are you moving that song and put it on a rhythm like that, toom, with so much beat on the bass? But that's just the few. I've learned to not focus on the few.
Good.
I've learned to put solid pillars around me, mentors who I be able to call and say, what do you think? Men who are gray ears, who walk up journey, that me no reach yet. Who's able to say?
Men with wisdom.
Yes. Who's able to say, Kevin, I've been there before. Relax and focus.
All right, took a little bit now about your growing up in all of four parishes.
Yeah.
Born in Westmoreland. Yes, explain that for us.
I was born in Westmoreland. Some of Jamaicans know my story, but being born to a 14-year-old mommy. 14-year-old.
Oh.
I don't have to go into the details of what that struggle was, but it was tough. Born in Westmoreland, came up to Hillshire after a while, moved to Maxfield Avenue. From Maxfield Avenue, I think I moved about four times on Maxfield Avenue. Mm. Let me call out the road
starting
so you can know
age,
me at dark.
What age did you
That was like.
There? What age were you when you went there first?
That was like 10, 11, 12, 13, 14.
Right up, okay.
Freeman Lane. Mm-hmm. Big up. Pretoria Road. Mm-hmm. Nelson Road. Maxfield Avenue. So we used to walk across Trenchtown every day. Trenchtown, Tank. That was my that was what I call home. With the tear pants, but no shoes.
Up to when?
14, 15, 16 years of age.
Up to 16. So you spent like what?
Most of my teenage life living in the inner city.
Okay.
And I never call it ghetto. Ghetto is always here. It's how you approach it.
Yes.
And I went to Melrose All Age. Yes, Melrose All Age. From Melrose, I went to Jose Marti. Jose Marti to Camperdown. Camperdown to 1 year at Exed, and then UA.
For your music, where would you, to which of these places that you've grown up in,
mm-hmm.
would you attribute most of the influence?
Boy, I must say Westmoreland, my early years, when I watched my mother struggle with a little flour in her hand, just enough to make one little dumpling, put the plate in front of me, cut it in a four, and I could never eat half that dumpling. I would eat half of that dumpling and pass the plate over to her. My mom told me that, because I couldn't remember that. And when she would sit and tell me that story of how there would be no food in the house, and me as a baby would walk across in the cane piece, and I was fat, you know. So when I leaned upon a cane, it broke.
So she was feeding you well. She was a teenager, but she was making sure that she's cared for.
Mom,
is it?
You're my hero. You are my hero. Daddy, big up to yourself. But mommy, hero. So it's those days, and then Maxfield Avenue, where you grew up around everything, my brother, everything. Gun, cook, everything, weed, everything. And you had a choice. It was there. Mommy, I know you're watching this, but I've gone before. Mm-hmm. Challenge to just do it. And I've said, respect you? No. School.
You made that call.
Gun. Boss it. I say, out of respect, my brethren. My heart not dead, son.
Where did you get that resolve, that strength, the strength to do that? Where? I mean, I know you.
You asked the question, and I'm asking the same question, too.
Yes.
I have absolutely no other name to say that's it, but God. I mean, He was there when I didn't even know myself, when I didn't even know why may I do this, why would I do this, why would I stand up? When the brethren said, I go down the road, go do this, I would say, it's all right, I'm going to my yard, I go, there's nothing in the yard to do. I'm not going to take my book, but I'm going home. I don't know what I'm going to do. Whole road empty because all the man them gone on the road, but I'm here, I'm good. Big up to Mark on Maxfield Avenue, because it was like, when I lived on Maxfield, Mark was Miss Patsy, blessings. That's his mother. It was two of us who push each other. You see, when there's nothing like having a companion when you're going through tough times. Mm-hmm. One, just one person you want to help you stand up. When the strata bus would upon my face, I study the same way, study for exam. You get this, all right, you're good. Just one person. Sometimes these guys going through in the inner city, sometimes they just want one more person to believe in them. And me and Mark was like this. We pushed each other. I passed, and he's now a good, successful fireman. I've been there. I've been held up, coming in late. Virgin said, yo, where you come from? I said, boss, yeah, come home. Oh, you? Okay. Gun in on my side, you know. I can feel the cold steel pressing against you. And then so many other areas where I could have been, I was caught in a shootout, and so many people were just at the wrong place at the wrong time. I can never get up and say, I'm going to pop my collar and just say, I'm the boss, yo, you know? I'm nowhere yet. There's always somebody need to know that, yo, you're in the zinc fence, community, all that's around the zinc fence, but the zinc fence don't define you.
Yeah.
You can rise bigger, you can become the doctor who you want to become. You can become the liar who you want to become. The gun does not define you. And the community that you come from does not define you. You can step out of that.
Ultimately, where are you heading career-wise?
My focus, my brother, for now and for the next 10, 15, 20 years mm-hmm. is to impact this generation in the deepest way possible. And if you notice, if you hear what I talk, which means it might not just be music.
Okay.
My whole ministry might branch to many different areas because on everybody listens to music. Somebody might read a book. As a matter of fact, I'm an author. I wrote my first book in 2015.
Yes, we should have asked you about that, yes.
So we're trying to find many different platforms.
And what is the book about?
It is the background behind my second album.
Okay.
The stories and my experience and so on. Mm-hmm. So you ask me, my focus is to just to hear what God say and just follow through.
Follow through. So that means he can take you anywhere?
Anywhere.
And there is a new project coming out?
Yes.
A video project?
Goodbye World.
Goodbye World. That's the title of the song.
Goodbye World. Hashtag. Anything you do on Instagram or Twitter, hashtag it for me. Goodbye World. May 16th, it's gonna drop. It's gonna be
okay.
Big. World, I know, on stage is all across the world. So once you go to my YouTube, I'm gonna make sure Winfred have it. But from his page to my page, Kevin Downswell YouTube, Instagram Kevin Downswell, Twitter Kevin Downswell, Facebook Kevin Downswell Ministry, it will be all there. Goodbye World, video drops. And that's track number one on the new album.
All right, so let's give them a bit of it.
Let's do this.
Goodbye World.
Well, if you know what I want, let me see everybody hands go up, up, up. Let me see you wave it in the air. I wave it like you have no fear. I made up my mind to go God's way the rest of my life.
Were you the only one for that 14-year-old?
No, I have two younger brothers and a younger sister. LaToya, that's my baby sister. I still call you baby. Yes, you're my baby. Even though you're 17 years old, you're still my baby sister.
Okay.
And my youngest brother, who is 30, mm-hmm. and my other brother, Orin, and my other brother, Brian. Mm-hmm. So I'm brothers and I have a sister.
Everybody jump, jump, jump!
Kevin! Thank you so much, sir, for coming and sharing right here on stage with us and ministering to us and inspiring us. And so there you have it. Kevin Downswell, a story of great inspiration. Winfred Williams, on behalf of all of us, thanking you for joining us. Do join us again next week for more on stage.
Big up the sun. Well, if you know what I want, let me see everybody hands go up, up, up. Let me see wave it in the air. I'm waving like you have no fear. I made up my mind to go God's will the rest of my life.
Thanks for watching our video. If you're not yet a subscriber, click now and be on stage. Always.